When you hear the phrase killer hair, you probably picture a sick mullet. You know, some super cool do. You probably never mistake it for anything literal. But if you venture outside the mammalian branch of the tree of life and onto another limb, you'll find the owners of some truly killer hair. From switching on the immune system to fighting off insects in the most metal way possible, here's what plants do with their killer do's. So what we're actually talking about here are tiny protrusions called trichomes, and a wide variety of plants have them on their stems, leaves, and other surfaces. While they generally resemble tiny hairs, they come in a handful of varieties. Some even secrete chemicals to help the plant defend itself. And that's only the beginning of what a bunch of teeny tiny hairs can do. For example, how does growing more food with less water sound? In a 2017 study in the journal Rice, yes, that's a journal, researchers bred a gene into a domesticated strain of rice that caused them to grow more trichomes on their leaves. Their hairy strain lost less water during photosynthesis compared to the original, though the plants also got hotter during the day. The researchers think that the extra hairs are affecting something called the boundary layer, which is a layer of air around the leaf, and are making it harder for water to pass through and escape the leaf. They hope this could help us develop crops that resist drought or require less water, which could be useful in the future. But if, unlike me, you've ever had to use a blow dryer, maybe you're thinking, yeah, I know hair traps water. Don't worry, I'm just getting started. Trichomes in arabidopsis, a plant in the mustard family and darling of the plant genetics world, not only help the plant detect rain, they also help it fire up its immune system. Publishing in the journal Nature Communications in 2022, researchers showed that trichomes are able to detect the physical impact of raindrops as well as other mechanical signals. Once the trichomes detect the raindrops, they send out a pulse of calcium to the surrounding cells. That pulse cranks up the expression of genes that help the plant recognize invading pathogens. But why rain? The plant hasn't detected any viruses or bacteria or fungi, just a gentle shower. The researchers emphasized that a lot of plant pathogens can spread by raindrops. Just like how your mom told you not to go out in the rain or you'll catch a cold, it seems plants gear up whenever it rains to protect themselves from what comes next. But while that's cool, I promised you metal. And now I'm gonna deliver. The horse nettle plant uses its hairs to tear apart caterpillars from the inside. These plants have spiky, resilient trichomes that pass through the digestive tracts of caterpillars intact. What's more, they're wreaking destruction as they go. In a 2017 paper, researchers documented that the guts of tobacco hornworm caterpillars were being stretched, punctured, and torn. Their words. They also showed that the caterpillars preferred to avoid diets full of spikes, and it's no wonder why. They even went the extra mile and showed that silverleaf nightshade, a plant with similar trichomes, produced similar results. But tobacco, which has different trichomes, didn't put them off. But there's at least one strategy even more brutal than ripping apart an herbivore's guts. See, plenty of plants have defensive trichomes like the horse nettle. Some of them are specifically referred to as hooked trichomes and can actually capture insects that encounter them. And for a while, researchers assumed this was a relatively passive process that would occur when insects walked across or bumped into a trichome. But in yet another study from 2017 in the journal Frontiers in Plant Science, one group showed it can be a bit more personal. In the paper, they looked at leaf miner flies interacting with plain, boring old kidney bean plants. And some flies' legs did get trapped, which is about what fly part you'd expect to bump into trichomes first. What the researchers saw most often, however, was that flies became impaled when they extended their mouth parts to feed. And second most often after that? Well, female flies have an organ called an ovipositor that they use to deposit eggs. And when a female fly went to lay eggs in the presence of a trichome, well, these flies remain trapped until they struggle free, and that just can't be comfortable. Even if they escape, they're scarred for life. On the list of effective predator defenses, I have to rate this one pretty high and pretty hardcore. So there you have it. These are only a few examples of what trichomes can do, which just goes to show you that before we invented the Rachel, Mother Nature already came up with totally killer hair. Thanks to our patrons on Patreon for supporting this channel. We couldn't get to dive into these killer topics without our community of Patreon backers. Plus, our patrons get access to a whole bunch of perks, like a patron-only Discord server and a monthly exclusive podcast. If that all sounds good to you, head over to patreon.com/scishow to learn more. That's patreon.com/scishow. Thanks for watching.